everybody to Craft Chocolate TV. I'm your host, Dylan Butterbaugh with Manoa Chocolate. And today we're gonna be talking about grinding and texture and micron size. And so we've got some tools here. There's different styles for this. We really are going for a very tight distribution curve of the microns or particles that we're grinding. And so the different machines are really important in this process. We started with stone grinders. And what we were noticing is that the micron size would be as fine as 5 and all the way up to 25. And that was a very large distribution curve of the microns. And so we wanted to tighten that up because we thought that the texture would get better. And there's no right or wrong here, it's just the style that we're going for. There's also things like stone ground chocolate that are purposely gritty. And so there's no right or wrong here, and this is a style thing. But we wanted really nice texture that felt silky and smooth. And so we looked at other machines like 5-roll refiners or 3-roll refiners. And in this case, we ended up with a ball mill. And so the ball mill, we can get the texture pretty much to between 16 and 18, which is what we're shooting for. And so that when we eat a piece of chocolate, when you chew on it or put it in your mouth and move it around, you don't get any grittiness. It's just that really silky, smooth finish that we're going for that carries flavor really nicely for the style that we are making. And so we've got some tools here. Originally, the way we would test the micron size is we'd dip a spoon in the grinder, I'd put it in my mouth and I'd chew on it. And I'd feel like a wet sandpaper on my teeth, and that way I would know it wasn't finished and I'd let it grind for another day. And this is in those whetstone grinders. But what's happening in there is there's a piece of sugar. Sugar is a crystal, right? And so it's going under the stones and it fractures, and you got one piece that gets maybe stuck on the side and another piece that continues to get fractured repeatedly and getting very, very fine, which is when you get that 5 micron size. And then the other one kind of stayed the same size unless you continually scraped the side of that grinder or the shaft of it or the inside of the wheel. And so in something like a ball mill, we load everything at the top and then it goes through something like 80,000 little balls that are getting agitated, and as they rub together, that is refining the chocolate really evenly. And then it goes all the way to the bottom, there's a pump that pumps it, puts it back up and drops it on the top, and then it goes through all the balls evenly again. And so that's why that distribution curve is very similar. So once we were dipping the spoons and tasting it, we'd also use the grindometer, and this is how we actually, it was a game, how we'd actually see how close we were. And so the way this works, and this is, whatever that says, is the company we got it from. And we also found out we were quite silly in the way we were using this for years. We would start at the bottom and put a piece of chocolate and we'd slide all the way up. But in reality, what you're supposed to do is start at the top and go all the way down, because there's numbers here, 5, 10, 15, 20. And what they're representing is the micron size would fill in up to that point. So we're gonna put a dab of chocolate at the top, we're gonna take a squeegee, we're gonna go all the way down the face of it, and wherever it stops filling in, that's approximately the micron size that you're at. So let's go ahead and do that right now. I'm just gonna take the back of a knife, and you're supposed to do this when it's kinda hot. So we're gonna put it there. And then you also wanna make sure that your scraper, your squeegee thing, is got no nicks in it. In this case, this one does, it's very well used. And so we might see a line in there, but we're still gonna get a very good idea of what this is. So you can see here, we're somewhere around 22 microns. Now, because this has been sitting out, it's not as hot as it should be, so I should probably do this again. But this gives you an idea. You know, you can see where it starts to really break up right in between this 20 and 22 area. You see some bigger pieces over here. You can see where the scraper was nicked, so you got to ignore that part. But this is how we can tell how fine our chocolate is. And you're going to have to test this at various times in the machine, when you're, especially in a ball mill, because you know, you come back an hour later and maybe you've over-refined. And what that would do to your chocolate is it would get this really peanut buttery texture, which maybe you like, maybe you don't, but it makes it much harder to work with as far as tempering. So we're going somewhere between 14 and 20 microns, I think chocolate is a great texture at. So this has been another episode of Craft Chocolate TV. Thank you for watching. Aloha.